this is Solar PVTV from Intersolar South America 2016 from Sao Paulo. And we are together with a person who is building dreams of Mr. Wang Chuanfu here in Brazil. Hello.
Hello, Thomas. A great pleasure to be here with you and the viewers of Solar PVTV.
So, Adalberto, I had an opportunity to speak with your colleagues in Munich about the strategy of company, about the products, etc. But what was very interesting that actually the company is focused on realizing the vision of the founder of the company, who is, let's say, I would say the first person before even Elon Musk, who invented the idea of having three products which are helping to build the sustainable world: solar, PV, storage, and electric cars. So how does it work here in Brazil?
Yes, Thomas, you know, BYD was created by these three dreams, you know, solar energy, affordable solar energy, efficient way to store energy, and electrical mobility. And since we have started all these three business, we have grown globally, delivering a little bit of each of the solution. And for example, last year we got the award for United Nations for large corporations for the zero emission ecosystem. So this is what we are talking about in Brazil too. Brazil also has a very clean energy matrix. We have hydro plants, but the way we used to do hydro plants in Brazil was big, large water reservoirs as storage of energy. But nowadays it's very difficult to continue doing that. There's all the environmental, social impact. So our three dreams in Brazil are perfect to the needs of the country now, because Brazil has a huge potential for solar. We've seen what the market grew last year, this year. Next year is gonna be a tipping point, I think, where solar market is gonna grow very fast. Energy storage is a really efficient and good way to store energy and help renewables to play, and electrical mobility. Like Brazilian cities, like many cities at the developing world, we do have a good public transportation system in some cities, but most of the cities, they don't have a good public transportation system. So investing on electrical bus, it's not only a solution to improve public transportation, but also to reduce pollution, improve the quality of living, reduce noise, and make cities better. So our dreams in Brazil of electrical mobility, storage, and solar are becoming a reality. We had our first factory, which opened last year, with solar, with electrical vehicles. We already sold the first electrical buses, the first electrical cars for car sharing, electrical taxis. So we are pretty happy to help develop this market in Brazil. We are, in 2 years, we are market leaders already on this. Energy storage is an area which is growing, just started. The market is still not there, but slowly we will see probably in 2016 and 17 the first projects deliver. And solar, look at the size of this fair. Intersolar is growing year after year. There's other solar fairs happening every day. So we feel
we had to hide in the meeting room, yeah, because it was too crowded.
Yeah, for sure, that's true. Our booth is a little crowded today, but that's what it's nice to see that. Although Brazil faces this difficult political momentum, this kind of challenging economical environment, which this moment we are living is not because of Brazilian macroeconomic fundamentals roots. You know, the thing is that there were a lot of mistakes done in the last few years regarding fiscal policies, and this made the country become very unstable and fragile. But the situation seems to be much better now. And we all believe that the market is going to grow and the economy is going to be stable once again. So our three dreams, which are already a reality, we can see we have electrical vehicles everywhere, like Europe, in Japan, in China, in the US. Our new factory in California, it's producing more electrical vehicles than any other manufacturer in the US in just 2 years of operation, you know? So I really believe our dreams, our chairman, Wang Chuanfu, his vision for the future is becoming a reality here in Brazil, too.
You know, when we connected on LinkedIn, I was looking at your profile, yes, and I saw that you are working for C40, you are working with the Clinton Climate Initiative, so you are, let's say, a bit kind of clean energy sustainability maniac. Yeah. So how did you start your adventure with BYD?
Yeah. Well, my first job was on the Secretary of Environment at the City Hall of Sao Paulo and the Secretary of International Affairs. So I had a 10 years career working with local government. And working with cities, it's a really challenging, but it's such an incredible opportunity, because working with cities is you are able to do projects and help deliver initiatives which really improve people's life, you know. And when you are the private sector, it's also great. The private sector plays a great role. With all the private sector, you could never deliver the solutions we need. But the thing is that the cities have been leading the way in sustainability for many, many years. If we see everything that happened throughout the climate change discussions in Copenhagen, you know, in Lima, now in Paris, federal governments, they're much slower to deliver the solutions
they are
required.
More far from the citizen, yeah?
They are far from the citizens. There's so much more challenges that they have to deliver. So cities are taking the way. Look what the C40 mayors have done, you know? The C40 has a report that shows that their mayors, which represent something like 500 million people, 25% of the GDP, the global GDP, you know? They have done 2.5 more initiatives to reduce CO2 than the other mayors.
Yeah, we had an opportunity to speak with the mayor of Sydney in Paris, yeah?
Yeah, Sydney is a great example. Also Melbourne in Australia. Well, almost all our major players, the major cities at the C40, they are being the leaders in their way. And the thing is that clean energy, sustainable ways to take care of the waste management, public transportation with electrical buses, bus rapid transit, bicycle, improving pedestrian facilities, energy efficiency on streetlights, energy efficiency on the public buildings. There's so many water and how you manage efficiently the water consumption and where the food comes from in the city that they grow. If the mayors that control almost all these powers, the mayors are the guys that have the pen to make the laws, you know? They have the budget, they control the power, they can do it. So we are seeing, like the C40 city, for example, action. And companies like BYD, which are leaders, we are a technology-based company. We are an innovation-driven company. So we are very close to these pioneer cities, these leaders, because they are asking solutions which are all part of our vision. So that's why we are growing so much in these cities that are leaders. And you can name it, you know, from London to New York, Los Angeles to Paris, or, you know, Tokyo in Australia, here in Brazil, all of them. Somehow they have been talking to BYD, they have been using our electrical vehicles, we have been adding electrical solar systems in some of them, just because the market opportunities for clean technologies and for sustainable low carbon technology are there. We don't need subsidies, we don't need only incentives. Of course, in some markets, in some areas, we still need some barriers to go down, some incentives here and there.
But then there will be only just clean disruption. Yeah,
yeah, but it's just as there's a ramp up of the technology. So we see here in Brazil, now the city of Sao Paulo is going to inaugurate 500 kilowatts into its one of the most beautiful parks here. Our partner, they use it, our pannels to deliver there. It's going to be the largest solar there. They're putting electrical vehicle charging. You know, the energy utility are putting electrical vehicle charging all over the way between Campinas, Sao Paulo, now Rio, the
beach. Step by step.
So solar charging, electrical vehicles are becoming a reality. Unfortunately, electrical vehicles still pays more taxes than normal vehicle in Brazil. That's one of those things that nobody understands why.
It's your job, yeah.
Well, that's part of our job to do. They did reduce import tax from 35 to zero, which already helped. But IPI, which is the industry tax, we pay 25, while other cars pay 8, 11, 13, or 25, depending on the performance on the car. So, well, anyway, the new auto regime has already mentioned to the market that they will shift from a local content incentive, which happens now, to a efficiency scheme. So most efficient cars in the future will have more benefits, and that's where we win. As you probably know, all the incentives done by the US or the Chinese government, our vehicles are always the ones that get more incentives from the government, because normally we are number one, number two at all the lists of energy efficiency for vehicles. So I feel that there's already solutions that the market itself is buying, and they make sense. So they're just gonna grow, and that's it. And the companies that don't realize that the market has changed, that sustainability is up there, and the companies that don't move to low carbon solutions, they will become part of the past.
Exactly. And I think like 1 or 2 weeks ago, you had this announcement about your factory here in Brazil. Could you just comment on that? What is the status and when you start the real production?
That's wonderful. Yeah, it was great news for the market, for the Brazilian market. We are finally going to inaugurate very soon at the end of the year our solar farm, our solar factory. We start with 200 megawatts production.
I hope you don't forget to invite us, yes?
No, you'll be invited for sure. And we hope also to ramp up for 400 megawatts very soon. The good news is that we are already going to produce our newest technology, you know.
50 years of guarantee?
50 years lifetime for the solar panels. It's our new double glass EVA-free panels. So as you know, it's a silicone glue and not an EVA solution. So degradation is much lower, 0.3 against 0.6. PG-free, snail trail free. It's just like the best of the technology.
It's great for Brazil, yeah.
Being produced in Brazil, you know, normally the top of the technology, they always start producing in Japan, China, US, Germany, then they bring the second level technology to Brazil. And no, we are starting our production with the top of the technology of the efficiency of solar panels in the world. BYD is the largest investment done by a company here. We have one more competitor using OEM and in a third party in the market.
Say that you are also contributing to the market, yeah? Not only
yeah,
just
the
selling.
Thing is that this shows our commitment to the market. Our competitor, which is also making local assembly, I bet he's also committed to the market. He has to deliver to their thing. But he decided to choose a OEM to do local assembly. Because it's a way to take out the risk from them. You know, it's less investment, it's less risk. They will have to deliver to their own projects and some small projects, but we don't know how feasible it will be for them to continue. But we know we are building our factory, and we'll be here for a long time. You know, BYD, like we have a 10 years plan for Brazil. You know, before as I worked for the government, 10 years at public local governments, your vision of the future is like 1 year, you know. You can only plan 1 year ahead,
depending on the elections.
Yeah. An election sometimes is and your agenda depends a lot on an election and how it goes, but coming to BYD, this was one of the first things that changed the way I was planning and doing business, is that the planning is in the long term, you know. I was a very lucky guy because my first job at the city of Sao Paulo, I worked with some of the best politicians in Brazil, you know. I learned a lot that. And after I moved to Clinton Foundation, like, President Clinton is just an incredible guy. He's such an inspiring, you know. The work that the Clinton Foundation has done around the world to reduce the price of HIV drugs, malaria, all the things with the public health. After the Clinton Climate Initiative, energy efficiency, sustainable waste management, public transportation, all the BRT, bus rapid transit, that became just a solution everywhere around the world. I met BYD at the Clinton Foundation, okay? Yeah. I was working for a project with the Inter-American Development Bank that was testing electrical and hybrid buses all over the world, Sao Paulo, Rio, Bogota, Chile. And we tested at that time 16 buses, and BYD bus was the best, the highest energy efficiency. And at that time, I saw how some people inside the Clinton Foundation, how they talked about BYD. You know, Clinton Foundation, these are people, really smart people, very wise guys. They have been doing, they're inside the Clinton Foundation, not because of money. They're there because they want to change the world, you know? And the way I saw my fellows inside the Clinton Foundation talking about BYD, talking about Chuanfu Wang, was like, this guy is a visionary. This guy is gonna change the world. And you saw Bill Gates, you saw Warren Buffett, all these leaders and visionaries on their areas. They were all working with Chuanfu Wang. So the first time I saw him, and I met him personally, and I went there to talk, he came to Brazil, and I wanted to know more about the foundation's work, and you know, some ideas. And in half an hour conversation, I was, man, this guy's gonna change the world, you know? Like the vision, how he was talking
and
about
I wanna
solar
help.
And
I wanna help him.
Electrical, so, you know, I wanna be part of this. So I was lucky enough at that time that BYD was coming. Almost 3 years ago, 2 years and a half ago, I joined BYD. And you see, in less than 2 years, we have two factories operating. We are launching the third factory for solar. We have contracts everywhere. We are with, although we had a very small team in the beginning, now we are growing. We are creating jobs locally. We are developing the local industry, local suppliers. And I share the vision of the company. So it's so different, you know, to work for something that not only you share the vision, but you know you are helping to deliver something which is helping people's life.
Yeah, because actually we are blessed, yeah? We are working for the industry which is changing the world in a positive way.
Yes, for sure. Solar is an industry that have a lot of side benefits, you know? The number of jobs per megawatt it generates, all the local development and the industries and indirect jobs they do. Like, all this story beautiful, but...
And positive people, yeah?
Positive people, but come on, like, imagine in the future, as solar energy develops, we're going to be able to create our own energy for your house, for your vehicle, and we might be able to be a fossil fuel free society. That's all what it's all about, you know, that's climate change. If we don't do something for climate change, we might not be here. My daughter, you know, every day I'm playing with my daughter, she's, you know, just starting to learn about the world and fascinating with the flowers and the plants and the way she looks at things, and I see her smile, and our generation is crucial to see if this world is gonna continue to be beautiful as it is, or if it's gonna be entering an auto-destruction phase. So solar energy, electrical vehicle, energy storage, the dreams that our founder was able to have 20 years ago, and now after 20 years, with almost 200,000 people working for him, 24 companies, 24 factories all over the world, we are helping to deliver that dream. So our factory here in Brazil is a reality. It's gonna be ready in the beginning of the year. We might expand and make more announcements in the middle of the year. The Brazilian president now, he's coming to China in 10 days.
Also quite significant, yeah, in terms of policy. Yeah.
Yes, think about Brazilian foreign policy is, in the last 50 years, has been growing a lot in our relationship with Argentina. Okay, Mercosul is the most important area of the public foreign policy of Brazil. Argentina is not only our neighbors and brothers, they're part of Brazilian economy, you know? Brazil depends on Argentina, Argentina depends on Brazil. So it's really symbolic, the work that these new presidents are trying to do together. But President Temer, if next week he is approved as president, we know there's still the impeachment process. Next week the Senate will vote and decide it. But if he continues, he decided to make his first international trip to China. And you know how diplomacy has some symbolic actions. And if he decided to make his first international trip to China, it shows me that there's something there, you know? Chinese companies are investing a lot. They're the number one investors in Brazil. Energy sector, infrastructure sector. They are long-term investors. So although we are facing this political challenge, they are not worried about it because they're looking in the future. So I hope to join this delegation. I'm gonna be there next week. So let's see how it's gonna come. But I really feel that we're gonna come back with very good news. You know, a lot of agreements, Brazil and China are gonna sign. Partnerships to facilitate investment, to open doors and projects, cooperation. I think Brazil and China are very complementary. We produce a lot of things that China demand. China has the technology and the money to help us with transfer of technology to produce. Brazil still have to learn a little bit how to get the best of this partnership. on agriculture sector, for example, we do export a lot of raw materials yet. We need to, instead of exporting corn and soya, we need to export more beef and chicken and more upper level. So there's still an area where Brazil has to develop because we don't want to continue to be exporting of raw materials forever. But now with these new investments, and BYD is a part of the story, for example, we are going to supply to Latin America the solar panels. So electrical vehicles. There's big deals happening now in Argentina, in Chile, in Uruguay, in Colombia.
And so we're going to have a lot of work, yeah?
I hope so. I hope we do. But the thing is that South America is a very integrated market. We are very complementary. We share the same culture. We share the same Latino spirit. Some people say it's hard to do business in Brazil, all over Latin America, and it's true. We do have a very complicated labor, fiscal, political system. It's true, it's complicated, but the reality is that South American countries are integrating themselves, so whoever comes first and helps to build this infrastructure will help this integration process, and it's probably going to be a market leader in the future here. So that's what we want. That's our vision. Our global vice president, Stella Lee, she's also a visionary woman. She's the one leading all the overseas work. And she comes often to Brazil, and she was here just 2 weeks ago for the Olympic Games, for the C40 event. Mayor Paes passed the chair of the C40 to Mayor Anne Hidalgo from Paris, which is also a great leadership. She has doing a great job there. Paris has announced 80% of electrical vehicle for public transportation by 2020, renewable targets. Well, Paris is also leading the way as usual, as they had for their whole life. So our vice president, when she was here, we can feel that although the market in Brazil is still unstable, she knows we are going to grow soon, fast, and our long-term vision to commit to the market, to transfer technology, to build the local industry, to create jobs, it's everything that we need. So,
and you are one of the guys who will help the company to build the dream of Wang Chuanfu here in the country.
Some polls show that sustainability is top issue in Brazil for the new generation. We really believe that this is going to grow, this is going to continue, this trend is going to continue. And it's so good to be part of this story here in Brazil.
Okay, thank you so much, Adalberto, for this interesting interview. And I wish you know that your and your chairman dream come true, and especially in your country. Thank you so much. And we will be following up, you know, your activities. So be prepared. Thank you so much. That was Solar PV TV together with Adalberto, who is helping Mr. Wang Chuanfu to realize the dream here in the country, in Brazil. Thanks for watching.